Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to set up a new Chromebook in ChromeOS. I'll be including the basic setup that will get you into your Chromebook, and stay tuned for more videos of mine that will cover how to set up other devices and change more settings. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the method. To set up your Chromebook after unboxing it, first use the power button to turn it on or connect the power cable, as this may start the device as well when powered. Allow the device to power on and start up. The first screen you see will be the welcome page, and you might get a message allowing you to turn on or turn off the screen reader. This is up to you, and when you're ready, click on Get Started if the language looks right. Next, we need to connect to a Wi-Fi network. Find your network on the list and click on it. Enter the network's password and click on the blue Connect button. Allow your Chromebook to connect to the network and then finish loading. The next page shows you the terms of service, and before accepting, you may want to uncheck the optional box below the terms, asking you if you want to send usage data. Once you're happy with that, read the terms and click on Accept and Continue. Allow the next processes to complete. Your device will check for updates and more. Once this is finished, you need to choose if you are setting up the device for yourself or a child. Select the option you want. We'll be using the option called U, so make sure the blue checkmark is next to your choice. Click on the blue Next button, and you'll now need to sign into your Google account. If you don't have one, click on More Options and follow the steps. Signing into your Google account allows your device to sync data with your account, so it will save a lot of time setting up your device, and you'll automatically be logged into your apps like YouTube and Gmail. Enter the email and password, and if you have two-factor authentication, you'll need to confirm this, so make sure you have your phone nearby. Once logged in, you have the option to sync your device to allow your account to transfer things like passwords and history between all of your devices. For example, if you save a password on your phone, it will automatically be saved for use on your Chromebook. You can customize these options later in the settings if you want. Click on Accept and Continue, and now you can choose to set a PIN for your device. You can also skip this if you wanted, but if you choose to add one, enter a memorable 6-digit number, and then confirm this by entering it again, and then tap on Done. Next, you need to read and accept the Google Play terms. If you tap on More, there are a few customization options that you can opt out from if you want. Click on the blue Accept button once you're happy with these. You now have the option to agree or deny permission for the Google Assistant to access app information. Next, you can choose whether you want a light theme, a dark theme, or auto, which changes automatically at sunrise and sunset. Select the one you want, and then click on Next. The final step here is to choose whether or not you want to sign up to receive offers and share feedback. Uncheck this box if you don't want them, and then click on Get Started. We're finally on our Chromebook, and you might see a few notifications and items to check here. These will differ depending on some of the choices you've made, but you should be able to dismiss these for now. On the screen, you'll see a helpful guide that includes some of the methods you might need, so feel free to check these out depending on what you want to do on your Chromebook. I'll now show you how to open settings so you can continue to customize and set up your device. There are multiple ways to open settings on your Chromebook. You can either click on the time icon in the bottom right and then choose the cog icon, or click on the app launcher in the bottom left and search for settings. Within the settings, some of the things you might want to change right now can be found in the device section. For example, if you click on touchpad, you can change the pointer speed, or if you click on power, you can check how much battery you have, and then what happens when the device is idle. Below this, on the main settings page, is where you can personalize things like the desktop wallpaper. Choose wallpaper, and then you'll see a collection of new ones to choose from. Back in the settings and scrolling down to the app section, you can find the notification settings. Click on notifications to enable or disable them for the apps you have. You can download apps by going to the Play Store, which is found in the shelf or taskbar at the bottom of the screen. It's the icon with the play symbol. If you scroll down to the bottom of the settings and click on Advanced, there are some more settings options. For example, you can change the date and time if it's not correct automatically, or change the language. That's how to set up a new Chromebook in ChromeOS. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.